Welcome to 2022 Art to Wear, the theme Dissonance. If you think back, we haven't been together like this since 2019. And as you all know, a lot has happened. But we are still back as a resilient group of creative designers here to show you their hard work, their creativity, their imagination, and looks that we've never seen before. We also benefit tonight for the first time ever, the Art to Wear One Look Challenge, all from the generous gift from Under Armour. These are gonna be projects that have been developed using their generous donations and fabric to give our students the ability to create things that we've never seen before using this gift. So we thank you. This is a turning point for Art to Wear. We've gone through some tough times, we've gone virtual, we've gone remote, but this is how it's meant to be seen. So sit back and enjoy the Art to Wear 2022 for this year and so many amazing more years to come.
I'm very excited, very thrilled, but a little bit nervous, which is fine. But all the students have worked so hard and tirelessly over the past year, focusing on skills and craftsmanship. So, to start tonight off, I'm delighted to introduce to you the First Experience Freshman Wearable Paper Project. But before we begin, no flash photography, please. Thank you.
Thank you.
as a fibers and soft construction student, it's important to understand that the process to create and utilize textiles has notoriously been harmful to our environment and health. However, in our fiber studios, we pride ourselves on embracing circularity and trying to extend the life cycle of the fiber we use. As designers and people who wear clothing, all of y'all, it is necessary to keep in mind to not only be mindful, but proactive about what you wear and what you consume. With that in mind, this next portion of the show is highly anticipated and has never been done before, the Under Armour One Look Challenge. This challenge came from Adrian McKenzie, who we adore, our Art Tour studio instructor. This challenge was open to the university and began with a generous donation from Under Armour. The student designers had the opportunity to create one look, and with all of the fabric that was donated, they could use as much as they wanted. So without further ado, the Under Armour One Look Challenge. As you all know, this is the first in-person Art to Wear show in 2 years, so welcome back. The looks you're about to see, yes, the looks you're about to see are emblematic of this year's theme, Dissonance, and our shared experiences as college students living in an unreal time. Dissonance with the designer's collection shows many facets, like the struggle of mental health, the evolution of community, and the future of technology. So please enjoy their personal stories and the way they interpret this year's theme.
My name is Owen Snape, and I'm a sophomore in industrial design. My collection is called Patched. So I was inspired by the thrifted clothes and secondhand things that I've purchased for the last 3 years. I've only had secondhand clothes in my closet. And so I like the idea of reusing and remaking things. And so I wanted to take that into my collection and create it purely out of things that have been tossed away and seen as trash, and to turn those things into something that I think is beautiful. And also play with the idea of how clothes are worn and composed. So each look has two different pieces on it that would normally not be put together. So for example, like a very masculine men's dress shirt with a skirt that is typically a women's skirt. So pairing things that aren't normally put together in ways that create something kind of off-putting but beautiful in its own way. I'd like the audience to take away that you can reuse things in ways that people don't see. And so once something has a completed life, it can start a new one in a different way. And so to just look at the things that you have instead of necessarily buying something new, looking at a different way that you can use it. Because I believe it's really important, especially now with climate change, just a lot of things going on environmentally, that we use the things that we have to the most and best that we can. So.
My name's Emma Anderson. I'm a junior in art and design. My collection's called Axiom. Axiom is like the guiding principle of something. And for me, I have this like guiding principle that in my like struggle with cognitive dissonance, one side is gonna prevail. So like my logical side will still prevail, even though I'm gonna have these like bad emotional experiences I'm gonna have to like kind of fight my way through. It's still gonna work out okay. For me, I know that I focused on like the cognitive dissonance portion of dissonance. So for me, that's my experience of kind of like these two contradictory thought patterns. Like I'll find that I'll go down an emotional side and I'll be like, oh, I'm so garbage, I'm so terrible. And then my logical side will have to like kind of haul me back out of the hole that I'm going into. So this collection's all about that struggle between this like logical and emotional side. I want my garments to be like super huge and kind of like obscure parts of the wearer. And like, I want to create a visual struggle between the garment and the model to kind of like represent that mental struggle that I go through. Making the collection has been an experience in kind of overcoming cognitive dissonance for me, like, because I'll start making it and I'll hate it and I'll be like, oh, I'm so garbage, and then I'll have to be able to like pull myself back out of that. I want the audience to look at my collection, or actually I don't even need to be my collection, I want to be that the audience watches the show and somebody in the audience who went through what I went through for my first show watches the show and goes, that's it. I want that for somebody else. I want it to be the event that it was for me. So I want like some kind of like lost high schooler to watch the show, get so excited, and then like work down that track for the next 4 years. Like that's what I want.
My name is Chiana Royal. I am a sophomore and I'm majoring in fashion design. The title of my collection is Eris. Eris is based off a Greek myth of the goddess Eris of Discord, and that has further symbolism in my collection's theme as it relates to dissonance. Techniques that I've used in this process include printing fabric. I've printed 5 different unique types of fabric for each of my garments. I've also used hat making, which is something that I didn't expect to use, honestly. And then I was like, why not throw these in here, right? And then also jewelry making. I've been making my own clay jewelry pieces for two of my garments. In terms of printmaking techniques, I utilized an online software known as Lectra to make fabrics. And when I was making my fabrics, I chose bright and bold colors, which further the theme of dissonance, because each garment has its own unique color. But also, all the motifs I used further corroborate some sort of animal that also has like a negative stereotype inflicted upon them. And that goes into my theme of like the female archetype and how there's negative stereotypes associated with that. So it's all under one large umbrella of symbolism, but every single thing I've done so far, down to the fabric, has been to further that message.
My name is Miranda Green, and I am a senior in design studies. The title of my collection is Technology as Armor. So the inspiration for my collection was really influenced a lot by these past 2 years in COVID, specifically being online, on Zoom. A lot of it was very technology heavy, just being able to communicate with people. And so I kind of tied in this like dichotomy of like who we are online, whether that's Zoom, social media, versus like who we are in person, like with our friends and family, and just who we are on like an everyday basis. For the techniques in my collection, aside from just sort of like basic sewing, like French seam, slip stitch and whatnot, I've leaned really heavily into incorporating these technology elements into my collection. So I've used a lot of CDs, I've used wire from microwaves and just like random things that students have brought to me, because I was like, hey, do you have any wires I could borrow that are free? I've loved the experience. I would never change it for the world. It has been a great way to end my senior year.
I'm Renee Harris. I'm a senior in art and design with a fibers concentration. The title of my collection is Discourse. At the beginning, I would say that my sewing skills, I was self-taught for a lot of it. There was a lot that I learned here, but I didn't have the opportunity to get some of the same instructions as people who were in the art to wear studio. So there was a lot I had to learn. I did some pattern making, some things based off of clothes I already had, clothes my models had, and so it was a lot of trial and error in that sense. I think the biggest takeaway from Discourse is that we all think differently and come to different conclusions, and it's about how you communicate that, how you go about reconciling those differences, how you introspect on your story and other people's stories. And I just want to open this up as an opportunity for people to think about how they can better have dialogues with people with different views than them.
My name is Madeline Therrington, and I am a junior in art and design. My collection is called Externalize. I interpreted dissonance in two ways in my collection. So first, I wanted to do, you know, dissonance is something that is, you know, different. It stands out from the rest. And so that's why I wanted to choose, you know, highlighting your emotions instead of stuffing them down. And so that was one way that I interpret it. And then another was through painting. So each piece in my collection, I painted abstractly to represent each emotion individually. And I used acrylic paint on fabric, which is not a traditional material that you would use with fabric. Traditionally, you'd use a fabric paint or something like that. And so, yeah, I want to do something different and doesn't necessarily go together, but in this case, it does. So I definitely want the point of my collection to be that it's okay to share how you're feeling and it's okay to share who you are. You don't need to hide that. And that it's not only okay, but it can be something really beautiful and, you know, a positive thing rather than just something negative. And so I hope that that's what everyone can take away from my collection and hopefully try to, you know, apply in their lives. So, yeah.
My name is Madison Smith. I'm a senior in art and design. My collection title is Facade. The inspiration for my collection comes from my own experience with self-expression and how much my environment can impact that. In my collection, I interpret dissonance through the layering of juxtaposing fibers and materials. For example, the glass dress on top of leather and a spandex, showing the clash between a bunch of different materials and the way that they're layered on top of each other and not really mingling as much. They're just kind of sitting on top of each other. Coming out of this year, I feel like I've pushed myself the hardest that I have all 4 years, and making a collection like this is something I've never done before and something this big. So I'm reflecting on all the work that I've put in this whole year, and seeing it all come together on the runway is going to be exciting. I'd like to thank all of my friends and my family, my roommates, RJ, Aaliyah, and Aaron, for all of their support. And I'd like to thank the whole Art to Wear team for putting this together. Thank you. Thank you.
My name is Leah Hauser. I am a senior in art and design with a concentration in fibers and soft construction. My collection is based on a personal narrative of mine navigating high-functioning depression. I kind of felt that there was a natural dissonance there given all of like the contradictions between how someone appears externally versus how they're feeling internally. And along with that, antidepressants is a very common treatment for mental illness, and I think that there's a very natural additive and subtractive nature there that kind of goes hand in hand with dissonance and creates a disharmonious feeling in someone. Well, my collection is really a culmination of like everything I've learned over the last 4 years. So I have a lot of screen printing that are all original prints, and I've screen printed them myself by hand. I've also done some dyes myself, so I dyed my own denim. And on top of that, I have just a lot of embroidery, specifically tambour embroidery, trapunto. What do I not have in my collection? There we go. So right now I'm stressed, but a week from now, I think I'm gonna feel very satisfied because I'm graduating and I'm like so happy with how my collection's been coming along. I'm so happy with the message behind it. I'm so excited to like share the story behind it. So yeah, I feel like I'm ready for everyone to see it.
'What's this?
It's an art project.
Okay, I like it. Picasso.
We'll be right back.
My name is Nicole Schumann. I am a sophomore. I am studying fashion and textile design, and the name of my collection is Sex. I wanted to take men and women formal wear, and I wanted to clash it, and I wanted it to really have mean something more than that, because when it comes to the sex that you are born with, it means that you're supposed to dress that way for the rest of your life. Like, you were born a man, you are supposed to dress a man. And whenever you look at my collection, you can obviously see the two sides clashing with each other, but I want to question people and push people and make people feel uncomfortable and have them be, why is this dissonance? Why does this look wrong to you? Because all I see is a person wearing clothing. Like, there should be nothing wrong with it, and it should make people step back. And like, I want it to bring emotion out of people. I want it not to upset people, but to make people feel something, and I want it to push people and ask them why it makes them feel that way. And I'd also like to thank my grandfather, who's one of my models. He also discussed a lot of the key points I was trying to get to with my collection, and he has supported me and encouraged me throughout this whole thing. So I'm really excited. Also, with Art to Wear, the whole production that goes behind even a runway, with getting everything organized and managed and booked and scheduled and informed, it's been a lot, and I've learned a lot. And I'm so sad that it's coming to a close, but of course, I'm also very excited for everyone to see.
Thank you to all of the designers and their dedication for the show this entire year. We'll now have one more final walkthrough with all of the designers and their models. For donating all of your fabrics. Thank you to Catherine Klinger and College of Design for supporting Art to Wear year after year. Thank you to Wilson College of Textiles. Thank you Red Eye and Max for helping with video production. And thank you Aveda Institute, Chapel Hill for creating amazing, wonderful hair and makeup looks. Thank you to Alpha Graphics for printing out our booklets. Thank you Stuart Theater and crew for allowing us to use your theater. And thank you, Jacob Hodges, an amazing assistant director. And a final thank you to two instructors, designers, and mentors. They have stuck by the entire chaotic year. And also, they have made my last 2 years wonderful. So Adrian McKenzie for Art to Wear Studio Instructor. Our Art to Wear faculty advisor. So, I want to thank you all for coming to the show tonight, and we look forward to seeing you at more Art to Wear events. Have a good night. Thank you.